Hey, it's Valkrin. This episode of The Strongest Unknown Champions is on Kale Jungle. Now, Kale isn't necessarily an unknown champion. Kale Mid has had play in the professional scene. However, Kale Jungle is much rarer and has immense potential. This is Kale Jungle in a nutshell. Really fast clear time, strong early ganks, amazing mid-game utility, and a terrifying late game. Kale is one of the few junglers in the game that can actually kite jungle camps. Ranged auto attacks combined with a large slow and movement speed buff, Kale can take almost no damage from some of the jungle camps if played correctly. Kale's ultimate giving invulnerability is a direct counter to assassin-style junglers such as Kha'Zix and Vi. Kale also has a lot of versatility. Kale can be played in almost all 5 roles, if not all 5. The main reason why I think Kale jungle is so strong is because you bring powerful utility ganks to every lane. No other top tier jungler can heal your allies, prevent them from dying, and two-shot squishy targets late game. But my absolute favorite part about playing Kale jungle is being able to prevent your teammates from dying. It's solo queue. Everyone's gonna make mistakes. Me, you, your teammates, the enemy team. Kale makes it so even when one of your teammates makes a critical error, there is room to deal with it. Now let's talk about Kale's damage. Kale has only 2 damaging abilities, and yet late game a Kale can kill a squishy target almost instantly. This is because Kale's Q currently has a 1.0 AP ratio, and Kale's E gives her a splashed ranged auto attack that has a 0.4 AP ratio. Combine that with a Lich Bane proc, that's a lot of front load damage. The best way to build Kale revolves around getting attack speed, cooldown reduction, a lot of ability power, and of course, Lich Bane. Most of the time when I play Kale jungle, I won't fully complete a jungle item. I'll get Spirit Stone, then I'll rush Gnasher's Tooth. That's because Gnasher's Tooth is such a strong item on Kale, and you also have a pretty fast clear time without it. However, if you fall behind early game, getting Spirit Stone and turning it into Spectral Wraith is still really good, especially with the recent buff to it. Kale is really dependent on your team composition. If you don't have a tank somewhere, or your team doesn't have crowd control, or you lack a way to initiate a team fight, or you just don't have a good target to use your ultimate on, then Kale jungle can sometimes feel out of place. But when your team composition is right, Kale jungle is absolutely godlike. In the next part, I'll talk about Kale's win rate, and a little bit more about Kale's abilities and why they're so good in the current meta. Kale has always pretty much had a very high win rate. On average, Kale has about a 52% win rate in solo queue. That's pretty freaking good, considering Kale has maintained that for a long time. And it really has to do with why Kale is such an innate part of a team composition. Kale does a lot of damage and has a lot of utility. Most champions have one or the other. You know, they have utility, but it's a sacrifice for damage. However, Kale is one of the few champions where you have utility. If you do well early game and get kills, you'll start doing a lot of damage mid to late game, and your early ganks, if we're talking about Kale jungle, are very powerful. In the current meta, Kale is good against assassins and tanks. Kale's passive gives you armor shred and magicka shred on enemy champions, stacks up to 15%. That makes it so you can burn down tanks much faster as a team, and your ultimate is a direct counter to any sort of assassin. If you're in range to save your ally, if an assassin goes in to burst down your ally, if you use your ultimate preemptively, you can then turn around and insta-gib their assassin and take the advantage. The bread and butter of why Kale does so much damage, especially in the jungle, is Righteous Fury. Now, it has a really nice AP ratio, but basically, if you get enough cooldown reduction, it'll almost always be available to you. And combine that with the movement speed bonuses from the early game Divine Blessing and the early slow percentages from Reckoning, jungle Kale has a very strong component of the early, mid, and late game. There's pretty much no weakness. The only way to really counterplay Kale jungle has to do with just invading Kale on her first or second buff and trying to prevent her from actually doing anything. Other than that, Kale jungle, very, very powerful. Just like the last video, guys, while the Reddit post is active, I'll be streaming Kale games and answering questions, so follow my stream and come on my stream and watch me play, and I'll be answering whatever questions you have about Kale or anything in general, and help you guys learn jungle Kale. Follow me on my social medias to stay informed for my newer videos, and I'll see you guys on my stream.